I came to this country in 1977, and I became a citizen in 1986. Actually, I almost was sent home when my working visa expired, but luckily, I was already married to my husband, who originally is from Germany. And so I was petitioned by my hospital under the quota of the Germans. Okay, so that way I was able to get my my green card and became a legal immigrant here. So anyway, as soon as I became a citizen in 1986, I petitioned for my family in the Philippines. My parents, I had no problem. Like in a few months, they were able to come, they were interviewed, and they were able to get their green cards. But I petitioned at the same time for my brother and sister. Right now, it took more than 26 years for the family of my sister to be able to get the visas, you know, to come here. So they arrived last July, from 1986 to July 2012. So it took more than 26 years. So actually, with all the news that I'm, you know, hearing and seeing in TV, you know, it's really, I thought it's so unfair that for people who are going through the legal system, it's taking forever, you know, to be able to come. And also, it's a shame that the productive years of those people we are getting is almost over. You know, like my sister and the husband, they came and now they are in their early 50s. You know, I thought the most productive years of their lives are kind of, you know, almost over. It's a shame, but I think for the sake of the children, you know, it's still a good idea that they were able to come here, and now hopefully, you know, all of them will become citizens. Now, my problem is that the oldest of my sister is now over age. When I filed my petition, of course, you know, the first one in line was the oldest. Now he is 24 years old, and so he is left behind. The three brothers are here, and the parents are here. Now the oldest is left behind. You know, and this really is bringing a lot of distress to my sister and her husband, and of course to the brothers too. So, in anyway, you know, my niece tried to apply for a tourist visa just to be able to visit the family here, just recently actually. He and his girlfriend, you know, applied for tourist visas. And guess what? It did not take 5 minutes. When he was asked, where's your family, and when he said that his family are already here in the United States, the interviewer immediately said, that's it, the interview is over, you're not getting a visa. And I thought that is so unfair, you know. And yet, the girlfriend who also applied, you know, she was interviewed, and when she was asked, where's your family, they're all in the Philippines, right away, she was given a visa to come as a tourist. Why is it that when there is already a filing for, you know, like a petition for you, you are not able to come to visit? And I think that is so, so unfair. Don't you think? Yeah. You know, that is so, so unfair. But anyway, in the case of my brother too, I petitioned for him, you know, and of course his family, at the same time with my sister. Right now, it's still, we are still waiting to hear from immigration, you know, what would happen. But I already filed for the application for the visas and everything, but I've never heard from them now for almost a year. So actually, it's about time for me to follow up and see what is going on. But I am really distressed with the case of my niece right now. So I hope there is help out there, you know, that I hope that my nephew can come, because it's really so distressing when one of your children, I could imagine being a mother myself, you know, to have one of your children so far away when everybody else is here. And he is 24, he has a girlfriend, and of course, you know, he would also want to, maybe, I don't know if he's planning to get married soon, you know, but I am afraid, I keep telling him, I said, don't marry, because once you get married, I said, the least, you know, your chance of coming to the U.S. will not happen. The more, it will be more difficult. So, you know, so now he's in that dilemma, because he will be 25 years old, you know, and now he keeps calling and asking my sister, do you think there's a chance for me to come? So I don't know what is the chance, and I don't know who is the person who will tell me what is the chance of him being able to come over. So,
thank you. Thank you, Bessie.